In today's video, I'm going to show you three ways you can transform MIDI into audio in Ableton Live. And if you stick around till the end, I'm also going to show you how you can take that audio and transform it back to MIDI. Brett Pontecorvo here at livekeyboardist.com, where I help keyboard players just like you with the ins and outs of Ableton, with creating excellent, stable live key setups and mastering sound design. If you're new here, please consider hitting that like and subscribe button. But without further ado, let's have a look here. So the first method for transforming MIDI into audio is to use a technique called freeze and flatten. So I've got a MIDI clip here. And if you stick around to the end of the video, I will tell you where this riff is taken from. It's one of my favorite songs lately. But we're going to go ahead and we're going to duplicate this track just so that we can keep the original MIDI in case we want to return to it. And then we'll click freeze. And you'll notice this has turned blue, but it's actually not yet audio. In order to transform it all the way to audio, I need to choose flatten. Now I can solo this track and you'll hear. It's also important to note that when you use freeze and flatten, what you're getting is a pre-fader rendering of that original MIDI clip. Or in other words, any audio and audio effects are included, but the level set with your fader on that channel is not, which means you get a pretty robust, powerful level. It also means when you drag it to another track, you may need to adjust the volume fader slightly. Method two for transforming MIDI to audio is to use a technique called resampling. So this can be done really quickly by pressing Command T to create a new audio track and choosing resampling from the audio from tab. And then I can hit engage here, and that's going to allow me to take a recording of anything that's currently playing. So when you're resampling, it's probably most useful if you're trying to combine multiple tracks into one track, because resampling is done in real time. And it's also important to note that what you are resampling is what is coming out of your master. So unlike freeze and flatten, which is a pre-fader, resampling is post-fader, and it will include any effects that are in your sends or on your master. So I've got my audio here, I've got resampling, I've got this record engaged. We'll turn this guy off because this is the audio from before. Here's my MIDI, and I'm going to click this and hit the space bar quick. Now when I hit this record button, it's going to count in, it's going to play that track and capture the audio. So now I can go ahead and solo channel 3, and we can hear the audio. And you'll see you've got your recording right here of that audio. So that's our second method. Now, method 3 is just exporting the audio, and I find that this is best when you are doing a really large chunk of audio, because it's going to be the fastest way, and then you can just drag that information back in from your desktop. So if you are in session view, you'll want to make sure that whatever clips you want to record are playing. You can select the channel you want, Command-Shift-R to open up your export audio and video settings. And there are a couple of things that we need to make sure are set here. First of all, in terms of what you want to render, if you're trying to just render a clip or a track, you'll make sure to choose selected tracks only, which will mean it's only going to pull out that one track rather than all of them. Now, in this case, I only have one track, but if you have multiple tracks, you can select those and it will combine them for you. In terms of rendering options here, we can turn off these unless you're using them. You don't want to render it as a loop, but this is actually where we really need to focus most of our attention to, because we want to make sure our bit depth, in this case, is set to 32. And that's because Ableton is already working at 32 bits, so if we render this file out at 16 bits, we're going to be introducing a slight bit of noise, and we don't want to add any noise until we absolutely have to at the very, very end of our creation process. So 32-bit, choose export, and I'll choose riff. And there we go. Now I have my desktop set up right here, so I can go in and I can see riff MP3. So I'll drag that file here, and now you can see we've got all of this audio. All right, and so you've made it to the end, and now I am going to show you how to take an audio file and transform it to MIDI. Now, this technology is good, but it's not all the way there yet, so this riff is not going to work. So I'm going to record something a little bit more simple. And I'm going to transform this quickly using our freeze and flatten method to audio. Now we've got this nice audio file, and if I want to turn it back to MIDI, all I have to do is right mouse click and choose Convert Drums, Melody, or Harmony to New MIDI Track. Now in this case, I'm going to choose Melody because these are only one note at a time, and Ableton's going to go ahead and do that. And let's see what we got. It usually is pretty good. So, not perfect, but pretty close. Also, I tend to really like the way they model sounds. I would definitely use this as an instrument. All right, friends, for those of you who are curious, the riff from the beginning is from a tune called Yours Is My Heart Alone, played by Oscar Peterson and Benny Green. I highly recommend you check it out. If you found this video useful, please make sure you click that like and subscribe button. And now that you have created audio, check out this video where I will show you how to flip that audio around and play it backwards. And I will see you next week on livekeyboardist.com.